The question is now, do we always use all the coefficients? So how many of these x of k should I choose? So there are two criteria, because the first of all, n should be a power of 2. A power of 2, and that's because usually the IDFT is a inverse fast Fourier transform, and this works best with lengths of n of power of 2. And then the other thing is that we just choose the number of xk we are transmitting information to set the bandwidth of our baseband with that. So we define the bandwidth of our baseband. So why is that? Remember that when we're thinking again of our frequency samples, so that's our x of k, and we had this index k here, that the smallest, that the, and if we're going from k to k plus 1, so from here to here, so this corresponds to fs divided by n. Yeah, so in other words, this is the frequency, that's the bandwidth required for one single bin here, one frequency sample. Bandwidth for one frequency sample. So then obviously, if we need a certain bandwidth, we are just setting a certain number of coefficients here, putting our information on a certain number of coefficients, and with that we are getting a certain bandwidth of the baseband. That's again a beautiful concept, that so if this is our spectrum here, so that's n half, that's n minus 1. So what people would do is, or usually what is done is that we are setting our signal somewhere here. Because remember, these are negative frequencies, so this goes here up to a certain k max, and then this k max creates a certain bandwidth, which is here just k max divided by n multiplied by fs. And then remember, we usually also use the mirror on the other side here. So mirror or negative frequencies.